5 years ago, thousands of Cubans lined up to pay respects to former Cuban leader Fidel Castro. He died on November 25, 2016 in Havana. His remains were buried at the Santa Efigenia Cemetery in Santiago de Cuba. Eduardo Carbonell was born to a humble rural Cuban family. During the Cuban Revolution, he became a professor of history. Carbonell says that Fidel Castro led the foundation to combat significant health crises like the COVID-19 pandemic.
Fidel designed development of scientific institutions which have allowed Cuba to develop 5 COVID-19 candidate vaccines, which makes us very proud of our scientists.
Professor Carbonell has also been a Cuban parliamentarian who says that Fidel's anti-imperialist ideas are present, particularly when Washington has enforced new sanctions against the island.
We live under a U.S. siege aimed at delegitimizing the Cuban government and damaging the people's trust in the socialist system. But we are advancing and changing our reality. And what that means is Fidel's legacy is followed by our current leaders.
A new government headed by President Miguel Díaz-Canel has favored important social transformations like the expansion of the private sector to reshape Cuban economy.
Fidel favored self-employment, and as a continuation of that, the Cuban government has set up micro, small, and medium-sized companies to meet the critical needs of the people.
5 years after his death, Fidel Castro is alive in the minds of Cubans from different walks of life.
Fidel Castro's ideas are not only present at a national level, but around the world, because he is an example to follow by any human being.
Cubans like Antoinelle and Professor Carbonell say that many will remember Fidel Castro as the man who shaped their lives and led the destiny of the Cuban nation for over 60 years and beyond. Luis Chirino, CGTN, Havana.